Prime Minister Narendra Modi with his Luxembourg counterpart Xavier Bettel held the first ever India-Luxembourg bilateral summit after two decades. With focus on increasing investments, areas discussed included financial sector, digital domain, green financing, space applications and impact of COVID-19 pandemic on the global situation. 2 weeks back, Foreign Secretary Harshvardhan Shringla took a week-long tour of Europe, France, Germany and the UK. After the US, Japan and Australia, India is looking at Europe with a renewed sense of camaraderie. While India is negotiating the new geopolitical order, Europe too had its own share of setbacks. China's geopolitics has been an eye-opener with their wolf warrior diplomacy. The Europeans too are responding to India's overtures. The European Union is looking at India as a more suitable alternative than China for strategic concerns and economic relations. India enjoys substantial trade ties and large investment flows with the EU. India and many European countries work closely at multilateral and plurilateral platforms on various issues of common interest. During Shringla's visit to France, subjects like Indo-Pacific region, maritime security, defense partnership, terrorism issues, global warming, sustainable development, climate change, technology and innovation were discussed. In September, Germany released its new policy guidelines for Indo-Pacific region. As Germany shifts from a China-centric policy, India fits into German crosshairs. India has seized the opportunity to remind the country how it fits a reliable and a strategic partner to Germany. During his UK tour, Shringla urged the British government to come up with its own strategy of the Indo-Pacific in line with that of the European countries. The rise of China and the imperative for a global rebalancing have added to the mix. A rules-based international order is achievable only with a rules-based Indo-Pacific, Shringla said. It was a clear statement that China has transgressed well-defined boundaries of peace and understanding that define mutual relations between nations. European countries have begun to revise their understanding of China and are looking afresh at the vast Indo-Pacific region. India fits in well into the new Indo-Pacific strategy of France, Netherlands and Germany.